Her love of jewelry and art has taken her from Iowa to Italy and back to Iowa again. We're in the studio today of Rachel Sims. And Rachel, thank you very much for letting us come take a sneak peek here. Tell us how this all got started for you.
We moved to Iowa when I was about 13 years old, and my teacher at the time encouraged me quite strongly and discovered my talent, I guess. So I went on to take every class I could at my high school, and which further led to going to the Rhode Island School of Design, where I majored in metalsmithing. And then after that, I continued on to the Creative Academy in Milan, Italy, to do a master's in luxury product design, which was pretty fantastic, yeah. And after that, I had an internship in Switzerland designing luxury watches, which was absolutely fantastic. And then I stayed there for several years as a junior designer for the watch company, and then came back to start my own business.
Tell me more about the time in Italy. What was that about?
When I was in Italy, I was doing my master's in luxury accessory design. I was at the Creative Academy, which is run by the Richemont Group. The Richemont Group owns companies like Cartier, Van Cleef & Arpels, Montblanc pens. And after that, we were given internships with the company. So we would have the CEOs come in and give us different projects to design, you know, possibly to be used with the companies, and kind of figure out what they wanted from that.
What did you learn from that?
It's a very different way. When I went to art school, it was design-based and more artsy. When I was at the Creative Academy, we were working for a company, so you really had to keep in mind the brand DNA and a bunch of different things that, as an artist, aren't really part of our lingo.
All right. Now, do you do metalsmithing and glassblowing?
I do a combination of both. I've been doing both glass bead making and metalsmithing since I was about 15. People have probably seen me for years out at the state fairgrounds demonstrating 12 hours a day with Suzanne Stevens. And you know, when I decided to focus on a major, I decided that metalsmithing was the way to go, but I couldn't quite give up my love of glass, so I've been trying to integrate the two, as you can see.
And where do you get your ideas, your inspirations?
Just about every place. I keep a sketchbook with me all the time, and it could be a color combination that I see, you know, in somebody's dress that inspires me, or a shape around town that I kind of jot down and play around with later.
What materials do you work with?
Primarily silver right now. I do, as I said, incorporate the glass as well, but I've been a little bit more metals driven lately and playing with texture and different forms.
And tell us about the glass blowing. That's fascinating to a lot of us.
It's very exciting. I mean, it's a very different way of working than metalsmithing. Metalsmithing is very, you know, linear and planned out, and it's really problem-solving oriented. It's little steps at a time. Glass is kind of flashy and bright, and there's a lot of color, and it's hot and fast, and you know, you just do it.
Dangerous?
Sometimes. We try to avoid that part.
Good.
But I do the glass bead making. Last year, I introduced glass ornament making, where people can come in and make their own Christmas ornaments, which has been a lot of fun. We've had kids up to adults doing it. And I will be doing a Christmas in July event where people can come in and get a jump on the Christmas gifts.
And you do teach quite a bit.
Oh, yes. Both through the West Des Moines Community Ed Program, the Arts Center. I have several classes coming up in the fall. DMAC is going to offer some of my workshops, and all as well in my studio.
That's fascinating. And where do you think this will take you next?
Always looking
for the next new thing?
That's a really good question. I enjoy doing what I'm doing, and I hope to continue building this and gaining a little bit more, not notoriety, but renown. Mm-hmm. And I maybe possibly a master's to teach at the university level.
All right. Do you like jewelry? Do you like earrings? Is there something?
That's a good question. The format changes. There's a lot of difference when you're designing for a piece for the hand, which has to be a little bit lighter, even if you're going big and bold, versus, you know, having to make two of the same thing for earrings. So it depends on the day.
Well, Rachel, sign me up for classes. It sounds like a lot of fun. Thank you so much for letting us come into your studios today. For KCCI, I'm Molly Cooney in the Artist Studio.
And you saw Molly's attempt at making an ornament. She says that her second attempt came out just fine. That's what she claims anyway. We'll have to see. Well, for more information on Rachel's designs...